Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama, the Truth Terrorist. I haven't been here in quite some time. I've been kind of busy lately creating my designs. Got a whole lot of new designs for you that I've been doing at www.ifama.com. Just thought I'd throw that in there. But anyway, you know, I get some of the most vilest comments on my webpage. And, you know, I tried to explain this before, but see, people, you don't know the depth of hate that comes out of the mind of men against women. And I just wanted to share a couple of them with you, and then I want to get into another area. But this comment came as a result on my Why We Need Men Part 1 video. And it's Why Do Black Women Give a Damn video. That's the video that I did. And it was a response to something. And so this person wrote, and his handle is Christians for Christ 1-on-1. This is what Christians for Christ 1-on-1 wrote on my page. He said, "As God, I say, the black woman is a wicked ass, hideously ugly creature who, just like Eve's wicked ass, is too happy standing upon the pedestal that Satan, via his Edomite people, put her on to even realize that the gods," he say, i.e., the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, "hates them, just like Satan, Esau, etc. Eve tried to be the head via laying up in the bed with Satan over 6,010 years ago, and the gods happily put that wicked bitch in her place. The black woman is going to hell and the lake of fire." That's from Christians for Christ 1-on-1. Then I get another comment from Get a Life or Get Some Psychological Help video, where Amunet369 said that they either had a very rough and warped life or came through a rough and warped womb. Now I'm going to address the last one first, because I think that, you know, if there's a rough and warped womb, how about a rough and warped seed? Have you ever given some thought that the origin of the problem could be a rough and warped seed, not a rough and warped womb? The womb is the carrying place. The seed is the seed. So perhaps the seed is rough and warped. Now, but for this last one, man, that is so vicious coming out of a Christian, I thought, you know, to use the term Christians for Christ. And this is just the tip of the iceberg of some of the vicious comments that I get. And I don't, you know, for the most part, I don't put them on my page. You know, I'm not gonna expose your eyes to that kind of shit. But, you know, I had a conversation with a brother over on my podcast, and it was his podcast, and I just called in on his podcast. But he made a statement, and he said that he didn't believe that there was any differences between men and women. And I gave that a whole lot of thought. I didn't just dismiss what brother said, but I gave it some thought. And, you know, I come to a conclusion that the only difference between men and women is physiology. Men are stronger than women. And I think that as a result of that, women have been socialized to behave and think in the way that they do. Just like any oppressed people who are oppressed by, you know, someone who's stronger than them or has more power than them, and they have to think up creative ways to navigate you know, around a powerful entity in order to get the things that they want or the desired effects that they require. And so I thought about, you know, black people and women as a point of reference when I came to that conclusion, is because women are socially conditioned to be emotional. They're socially conditioned to be considered more nurturing than men. And I think that men have just as much of a capacity to be emotional as well as nurturing as women are, but we're just socialized differently in a society that is ran by might. So I think that, you know, for the most part, women are have the mindset that they have, and this has taken thousands of years of conditioning and subjugation for women. One of you is familiar with The Art of War. That particular book outlines what do you do, what strategies you use when you come up against a formidable force. And sometimes you gotta step back. Sometimes you have to reassess your position and you have to approach your position in a different way. Now, I would look at it, you know, from this vantage point for women, if men in the society was made in a way or designed in a way where there was no physical violence against, you know, one or the other, I think our interactions with each other would be different. Our approach to parenting would be different. I think everything is based upon the fact that men are stronger than women and can subjugate women, you know, whenever they want. And it's only by those men who feel it's their duty to protect women against the overt aggression of other men that we have made such strides in the society as women as we have. And, you know, we just have some historical data to attest to the fact that given opportunity, and this is for black people and women, you know, for the most part, given opportunity, you can achieve whatever you desire. But it's because of these subjugations, these holdbacks, these threats against limb and life that we as black people and we as women have had to resort to different tactics in order to maneuver and navigate in the society that we live in. So I just wanted to share that thought with you because I do think that we are in this society, of this society, and that we've been conditioned by these societal norms or cultural norms that were put in place a very, very long time ago. I mean, thousands of years ago. And it's part of who we are now. But given opportunity, we have seen historically that we can, you know, kind of rise above those certain positions that we've been given to stand in. And so that's why I think that, you know, women and black people for the most part have adapted to a certain conditioning, you know, that is put upon us by those who are mightier than us or who have more power than we do. But given opportunity to break out of the cultural design, we do and can exhibit, you know, our fortitude in whatever arena that we wish. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist, and thank you for listening. Hotep, everybody. It's my lunch hour, and I got to get back to work. Peace.